It's a scary fact. 2023 was yet another year of record-breaking deadly wildfires. Actually, in the past decade, every single region on the planet suffered wildfires that were unprecedented in one way or another, all the way from Australia and the Amazon to Siberia and Scandinavia. There is no doubt we're transitioning to a new era characterized by more frequent catastrophic wildfires, the so-called megafires. But why is this happening? I'm Professor Apostolos Voulgarakis, AXA Chair in Wildfires and Climate at the Technical University of Crete. In this first part of my masterclass, you're going to learn what megafires are and why the world is experiencing more and more of them. First of all, what's a wildfire? There are fires in buildings and fires in non-built environments, the latter often being called landscape fires. When fires in landscapes burn in an unplanned or uncontrolled fashion, they're called wildfires. The emerging term megafires does not currently have a strict definition, but it is used to describe wildfires that are extreme in terms of size, intensity, impacts, or a combination of the above. You should also know that megafires are not only becoming more frequent, but they're also occurring more and more outside of the normal fire season of different world locations. Now, the reasons why megafires are increasing are manifold. Firstly, one key factor influencing the frequency, extent, and intensity of burning around the world is climate change. The rising air temperatures and the more intense heat waves in pretty much all parts of the globe cause more evapotranspiration from plants and less water available for them in soils. All this leads to drier and more flammable vegetation. High latitude areas, namely Siberia, Canada, Alaska, and Scandinavia, are experiencing these effects even faster than the average world region. You might wonder why. Well, that's due to the phenomenon of polar amplification. Put simply, polar amplification means greater climate change near the poles compared to the rest of the globe. The reasoning is simple. As the sea ice melts, the white surface of the Arctic Ocean that usually reflects a lot of incoming sunlight gets replaced with a darker water surface which absorbs more sunlight, thus leading to additional local warming. Of course, other consequences of climate change, such as decreasing rainfall and longer periods of drought, are adding to the problem in several regions like the Mediterranean and North America. Secondly, the rise of megafires also has to do with the influence of humans on fire ignitions. Human activities often involve the use of fire. And population growth in a variety of regions leads to a higher fire risk. You might think that more humans will always translate to more fires, but this tendency is not that clear-cut. There are areas that also experience decreases in fire extent when human activities increase. Let me give you an example. In African savannas, satellite observations suggest that burnt area is decreasing, and this is attributed to the transition to more organized agricultural practices and landscape fragmentation. At the same time, still within the tropics, other regions are seeing rapid increases in megafire incidents, even though they're also undergoing rapid agricultural development, but in a different way. A prominent example is Indonesia, where slash-and-burn agriculture has led to massive megafires, especially during El Niño drought periods. Now, are humans affecting megafires in any other way besides ignitions? The answer is yes, and that is via fuel management. Let me explain. The 20th century dogma that fires should be prevented from happening by all means led to forests in which both living and dead plant matter has accumulated to a great extent. This means that wildfires may indeed be prevented from happening for some time. Eventually, when there is a fire, it is catastrophic. Why, should you ask? Well, because it has very large amounts of vegetation available to burn. Plus, climate change is driving higher risks of fire, and human communities are being established in or near forests, which makes it even worse. So, to sum up, megafires are wildfires that are extreme in terms of size, intensity, impacts, or a combination of the above. There are several reasons as to why megafires are increasing. First of all, climate change, which leads to rising air temperatures and changing rainfall patterns. Secondly, human activities like slash and burn agriculture. And thirdly, over-preventing fires, which leads to an excessive amount of vegetation available to burn. Now that you know what the drivers of megafires are, let's move on to the second part of my masterclass and take a deep dive into the devastating impacts.